each step of the way, and I will always love you. I will always love you. Bittersweet memory. That's all I am taking with me. Goodbye. Please don't cry. We both know that I'm not what you need. And I will always love. I hope life treats you kind, and I hope that you have all that you ever dreamed of, and I wish you joy and happiness. But above all of this, I wish you love.
Welcome to chapel. We only have one announcement today, but it is a very exciting announcement. We will be announcing our council presidents for the 21-22 school year. So to help me do that, I would like to invite out this year's current presidents. So ladies, please come on out. All right, these girls think that they're just helping me announce next year's presidents, but I also want to take a minute just to celebrate them real quickly. This group of presidents has probably been the most flexible, the most creative, the most unwilling to give up in the midst of a very challenging year in leading their councils really well. So I want all of you seniors to cheer as loud as if this place was full of 600 people for these girls. You all have been amazing presidents, and we are sad to see you leave, but we are excited for the people you will pass the torch to. So I'm going to give each of these girls an envelope that has the name of the next president for their council in it, and they will announce who is taking over. We'll start with the really big surprise of student council.
Yeah, this big surprise. Do I really need to open it? I'll open it. Big surprise, you guys. Mary Kate!
Okay. Your next pick president's Willa Mermelstein. Congrats.
right, your next Honor Council President, Francis Crowe.
So Francis, Willa, Mary-Kate, please meet me out at the NIADS after chapel. We would love to take a picture of you as our next president. We are really excited for you girls. Thank you, current presidents, for helping introduce that. The rest of chapel today, we will be having a fine arts showcase, so I'm going to hand things over to Ms. Brock to introduce that.
Clip it. There. All right. Thank you for being here, and thank you for giving me all sorts of great props for your artists that you're going to be seeing all of their work up here. This snippet is taken from a blog called Lightfall by Matthew Robilliard. In his blog, Mr. Robilliard discusses the importance of color in game design, and he says, when you meet someone new, it takes the brain approximately 200 milliseconds to process a facial expression to generate a first impression. The first impression that can stick for a while and define your whole perception of that person. Now, imagine how fast the brain can process a simple color palette. In video games, the color palette is your first impression. It can set the mood of the whole game or generate emotions within you before you even start playing. If you plan on making an immersive video game, you absolutely have to nail your color schemes. Everyone knows at least a bit about color theory. Blue is sadness, red is anger, and you get it. A thoughtful color scheme can convey more, way more than the simple emotions like sadness or anger. You can induce complex moods like the thrill of an adventure or the suspense of a mystery. You just have to find and create the right color palette for the emotions you want to convey. If any of you have ever played a video game or played with the virtual reality setups in the library or looked at a billboard on the side of the road and looked at the artwork in the Frierson lobby, you are seeing a variety of color palettes. You are interpreting the scenes in the video game and you are reacting to them. You are forming an opinion of the game. If you have placed the virtual reality goggles on your head and driven the cars down the road, you are reacting to the virtual visuals and experiences the game creators devised for you. You may burst into a fit of laughter with your most excellent driving skills, and it has created an emotional response in you. If you are swayed by the billboards advertising a certain food as you travel down the road, your brain interpreted the images in milliseconds and triggered a response. And you ask yourself, am I hungry for Chick-fil-A right now? Should I get a snack? No. Or is it dinner time already? Should I get a meal? If you looked at any of the artwork in the lobby or scattered around the school, you may have responded to it saying to yourself, I really like that. I wonder how they did it. What paint did they use? That's a pretty cool way the artist painted the bottle or sketched the landscape or made the dress out of coffee filters. The artist really captured herself in her self-portrait. I would love to have that piece of art in my house. The artwork made an impression on you. You are you, your brain is yours, and you are different from the person next to you. Duh. I can read the directions for a project, and I guarantee each of you will interpret my directions a different way. Your way. Okay, I'm going to describe a piece of fruit. Close your eyes. And it's roundish. It's not a perfect circle. It's reddish in color. Even has flecks of green in it. It has seeds. It has a somewhat smooth texture on the outside skin. The fleshy inside is pale in color, and this fruit is really juicy. What fruit am I describing? Quickly turn to your neighbor and tell them what fruit you thought I was describing. Heard lots of things. Red grape, red apple, red pear, tomato, strawberry, raspberry, pomegranate, cherry, cranberry. The descriptive information was delivered to you, your ears heard it, your brain interpreted it, and then you made a decision and the image popped in your head, all in milliseconds. The art before you is just that. Each of these artists have interpreted directions from the instructor and have created some incredible pieces of art. Pieces that are very personal and represent the voice of the artist. Each artist interpreted the directions their way. You, the viewer, are interpreting the art before you, your way. Please take a moment to appreciate the heart and soul that is in this work, your work, and the work of your peers. Thanks.